We are the team of four from Manage, and we have conceptualized this business plan for a fortified chips. We have chosen fortified chips as our product, and the name for the organization is FICA Foods. As you know, that FE stands for iron and CA stands for calcium. These are the two minerals that we want to include in our chips. So that is the reason why we have named our product as FICA Foods. And now I'll introduce the fourth member panel of our team. That is Ganga Vasu ma'am, and she will be holding the position of director. And Nihar Ranjan Pradhan sir, he will be holding the position of marketing chief. And Sanprit Aditya sir, as he has done his graduation in food technology, he will be looking after the product. So he's been handling the position of product manager, and I myself will take care of the HR management. And I want to say one more thing, that we have decided these portfolios basing upon the interest and the performance of people. Whereas the most important thing that we need to focus is, we are all the co-founders of this organization, and it is a brainchild of our everyone's interest. And next will be continued by Nihar.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, a very good afternoon, everyone. This is Nihar Ranjan Pradhan. The first idea came to one of our teammates who was doing his research on fortified potato chips. The idea came to our mind because almost 69% of Indians are suffering from malnutrition according to the FAO data. 39.86% of people are suffering from iron deficiency, and almost more than 50% are suffering from zinc deficiency or are susceptible to the deficiency. All these are mostly confined to a demographic of children, young adults, or like oldest people. With busy and rapid life of Generation Z, the new unhealthy lifestyle is kindly leading to a less immunity life. Especially the ready to cook and the ready to eat foods are adding to it. Coming to one statistics, it has been found that fortification of iodine has decreased goiter by 90%. And also one study has found that fortified food market is going to be forecasted to grow at a rate of 6.3 between 2019 to 2027. The Indian market is showing growth in consumption of vitamin and enriched food. With growing health concerns, especially after this pandemic, the people's awareness to eat healthy and nutrient-rich food will drive the market of fortified food at a faster rate in the next few years. Also, with more disposable income with people's hand, the fortified industry will be fostered more. Our business plan is going to be on a fortified food for ready to eat and ready to cook. Our first product will be the fortified chips. Our tagline is hunger with tasty nutrients.
Wow.
We have done a market research for this. In our market research, we took a survey sample size of 132 and also done a telephonic survey sample of 19 people. We've inquired about how many people follow any diet plan or take any supplements. Around 2/3 of the people said that they don't follow any diet fad or don't take any nutrient supplement foods. That's a big reason for going for this fortified industry. Then we asked people about how much are they aware about supplementation of micronutrients in foods. As high as 3/4 of people replied with they know about it, but as due to previous data mentioned, now most of the people don't go with supplemented food. Paying extra buck is a problem for them. We asked people what they look for the most. What they look for the most while consuming the food. it is evident from the data that more than 50% of the people concentrate on taste and price. Only 1/3 of the people look at the contents or nutritional qualities of the food. Then we asked, why are they willing to pay any extra bucks to go for the more surplus nutritional supplemented food? A whooping amount of 82.7% people replied with a yes. And in further question, when you asked how much they are willing to pay, more than 50% said that they are willing to pay 10% extra. Coming to our business plan, according to the market research, with the market research data, we concluded that there is a big need of fortified food in the Indian industry, especially with the ready to cook and ready to eat foods. That's why we are going for the fortification in the ready to eat and ready to cook foods. Further, my teammate Sampreet will take over.
Thank you, Nihar. Talking about the business plan, when we actually had done our initial survey, we found out that there is a huge gap between the nutritional supplements and nutritional foods, especially in the criteria of RTE and RTC. So RTE is ready to eat and RTC is ready to cook. There is not much fortification done in that kind of department. So we came up with a business plan where our vision is to formulate the startup is a general partnership. We all are individual and are working in a partnership and our co-founders. And this startup will provide healthy fortified snacks to tackle our tagline, that is hunger with tasty nutrition. So it's not only the nutrition, because people correlate healthy with something boring or correlate healthy with something very tasteless or bland. But our motto is to tackle the hunger with tasty nutrition. Our mission will be to provide the nutrition supplemented RTE and RTC food pan India. So within 5 years, we want our distribution channels to reach all over the India in order to supply our formulated product. The goal for us will be to successfully establish a pan-India distribution channel and of innovative, healthy snacks and development of product line. So, however, we are going to start with potato chips, which I will be coming to later, but it's not the only product which we are planning to launch. That will be the first product and that will be followed by a line of products which will further establish our goal. And that goal is to establish a proper market segment for fortified food and our place in that market. So all these things, vision, mission and goal will be completed. And the first step we took was the development of the Fika potato chips. So it's fortified potato chips with the added iron and calcium, as the name suggests. So this potato chips is fortified and it's not like any other potato chips. It's much more healthier and much more nutrition supplemented. So people can not only just take the taste and flavor of the product, but can also derive the very various nutritional qualities which are generally not available in these kind of products. Nihar, please go to the next slide. So product description, it's very straightforward. Fika chips has added calcium and added iron. Both nutrients will be added as per the RDA of the as given by the ICMR. RDA refers to recommended daily allowance, and for calcium, like taking instance of calcium, we have an RDA of 1.2 gram per day per person. So we have to consume at least 1.2 gram of calcium, but our calcium quantity consumption should not cross 3 gram per day. So it should remain between 1.2 to 3. So we will be providing around 60% of the daily required calcium. That will be something around 0.8 gram per day. And that will have an efficient fortification bioavailability because our R&D has worked specifically for that. I'll come to that on later. But due to the enhanced bioavailability of the calcium and iron, the body will be able to absorb 80 to 90% of the calcium. That will make sure that our body is receiving at least 0.7 to 0.8 gram of calcium and recommended similarly about iron in 1 day. Talking about other description, other benefits, we have 3 flavors of these Fika foods till now. The salty flavor is right now completed and the flavor is totally made. The other 2 flavors are still under the research process and we are working on newer flavor innovation based on the indigenous flavors. That will be deriving something as in the chili flavor from Guntur or some Bhut Julakia flavor from Assam, and we'll be trying to incorporate that in our indigenously in our product so that it can be easily accepted by the people. Again, since we are focusing on the health aspect, we have produced both batches, the baked ones and the fried ones, and we will be separately selling both of them. But one of them, since we are talking about this particular product, we will be talking about baked chips, not the fried ones. Then this will be available in three different packs. That will be about different ways and different slides and that sizes, and that will be very, very beneficial in order to reach to the different kinds of requirements of the people. And again, it's quality ingredients and premium products. We are not compromising with any quality, and we are going to provide a premium product and at very affordable price. We have made our financial system and our pricing system as such that we are going aggressive into it, and we are going to provide it in a very comparable price, that it should not go out of the reach, because our survey has shown that they can pay more, but we cannot ask them excessively. So that will be according to that only. Nihar, can
you connect? Less. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Ganga, can you take over,
please? Yeah. Now, am I audible? Yeah.
Yes.
Hello, am I audible? Yes. Okay, yes. Now we are going to see the target market and the marketing strategy. For every business plan, this target market and the strategy is the heart of every business to have a better reach in the market. And the strategy which we are going to operate is, we are planning for both the strategic level and the tactic level. The tactics what we are going to implement is the most important thing for have a better reach. Now, when coming to the strategic level, the target market, the opportunities where we're getting and where to implement a product, who's the target people, and everything will be seen. And in the tactical, what tactics will be used is the product features and the promotion, pricing strategy, and the service, how we are going to provide, all those will come under a tactical level. And one thing, the most important thing about the Spotify potato chips is that we can hardly find people who don't patronize them. Like everyone, whomever, for in every party or in every occasions, everywhere people will be using the snack product, this potato chips. And what is the major additional advantage which we are going to have is that we are going to impart a nutritional supplement into our product. That is the main advantage which no one has ever tried it before. And the major focus are younger age children, adults, and everyone. Everyone can eat a product that is, this is not a fried one, that is the deep frying, which has an oil content, and everyone will be facing some diabetes and older patients. They'll be liking to eat snack products like a crunchy or chips one, but they'll be afraid to eat because of their health issues. So our baked product will have an additional advantage. And now we'll see the marketing strategy, what we're going to follow. Is that in marketing strategy, simply we cannot tell like it is the only marketing strategy. It is the heart of any business. And in marketing and sales strategy, that is publicity, how we are going to advertise a product and the pricing strategy, everything will be dependent. From a thorough market research, we got to know that 83% of the people are willing to pay extra if there is an additional nutrient content there. And 60% of the people are highly health conscious, health oriented, and we are majorly focusing on the customer centric. Our product is customer centric only. And most people and most brand, many potato chips and products are there, and everyone, they are focusing on the taste, brand, and the appearance, how they are going to crunchiness, all this. But now here we are having an innovative idea, that is an additional implement, that is the fortification of our product. And but the penetration, however, we are going to implement this new one, fortification one, but how that is going to get penetrated into a market, how the customers are going to get reach, that is the strategy what we are going to follow. Initially, if we opened a brand, this is a startup, but how we are opening are going, how we are going to open a product, that is the most important thing. If you open with a grand scale, with a party, by providing and everything, or like some flash mob and providing free of those things, that will have a major impact of reaching our product. Those are all the strategies we are going to follow. And for publicity, in every social platform, and YouTube, Instagram, and newspaper, radios, everywhere you're going to reach for having a better advertisement. And the pricing strategy, as we are already told, that this is a customer centric, and what a customer needs through our research, we got to know that they are health oriented. So that we have imported this, and the payment options, whatever building, in what method they're wanting to pay, or everything is available. Whatever the customer needs, that is the thing we are going to provide them. And the next, okay, next slide, sir. Okay, in the strategy also, the pricing strategy, as we are in a startup, we are going to get from the venture capitalist, as that is, everyone is not having any idea. Everyone is having some lot of idea. But the thing is, who is having an innovative idea? That is the major problem in venture capitalist, who is going to provide the loan. And our idea is the best one, that we are going for a fortified one. And we are also going to provide a coupon or any lucky withdraw. But this is a COVID situation, and now everyone is using data and everyone need that one. By having a proper coupon or lucky withdraw in our product, that will have a better reach. But due to this COVID, we can have a better reach out of that by providing some coupons and all. Coming to the next, that manufacturing and operational plans, we can have some fact that India is the second largest producer of potato. Commonly, first one is the China, and commonly they both contribute 38% to the world in production of potato. And in India, UP is the leading producer, and Bihar is the third, where we are going to launch a manufacturing plant. And in that, what is the most important thing that we are going to have is that near to our manufacturing plant only, we are going to implement a farm, that where we are going to produce the potato, so that we can monitor our product easily and can have the content, nutrient content which is needed, and everything can be implemented there only by having a proper monitor. And basically people will have a wrong notion that potato we should not consume or something like that. And but for everything, every snack, whatever we are eating, for any party or having any cold or hot drinks, they'll be preferring this potato chips for a side dish. And having an additional nutrient supplement will be an added advantage. And this potato is having high potassium, more than that of banana. That is the fact. And vitamin C, fiber content, magnesium, and everything is there. Along with that, we are going to have a fortification of iron and calcium. That will have a better reach.
Sorry for interrupting. Please go faster. There is no time.
Yeah, okay. Okay. And nowadays, what is the major thing we're facing is, in India, 16% of the potato is dumped into waste due to the post-harvest mishandling. So that we are going to this, coming to this manufacturing plan, all the raw materials, packaging materials, and everything is going to have a proper research and proper standard certification. Like for production of any processed food, we need an HACCP, ISO, and FSSAI certificate, and everything will be going to be tested, and we'll have a proper certification. And for processing, it is not a deep frying one. This is a baking one. So baked product will not have a much cholesterol or oil content, so that it can be taken by everyone, every age of group. And for this is the process flow line, how we are going to do. And that's it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, so next thing. Okay. So before, like, research and development is the next slide, and before starting the research and development, I'll just take up the question which Seva sir asked us.
No need to answer as part of it. You can answer later. Just in the questions.
Okay. Yeah. Fine. Yeah. So yeah. That answer will be there in my this
presentation. Yeah, that's right.
So yes. In my initial, in 2018, I was doing the initial research over the fortification, and I found out that there are various sources of the food waste from where we can fortify. For example, for calcium fortification, we can take eggshells. Eggshells are a great source of calcium carbonate, which is the most bioavailable type of calcium compound for our body. And that has been used and formulated in a fortification plan, which has also been patented. Like, the patent has been filed for that in the Indian patent office. And we are also working on the flavor innovation and product development department. And the whole research and development wing is being going very strong. And our company will be driven by those fundamentals of research and development. And the newer the product is formed, and we will be launching them one after the other. And our product has also been received all the clearances, and especially from ICMR, who says that it is one of the most bioavailable product available right now for the terms of fortified food. You can go ahead now, Niyar sir.
Business plans, 19 minutes over. All the best.
The most important thing is here, even after starting the business, if these numbers don't show in good space, then the plan and idea, however good it might be, the business will be a flop. And the things that I'm going to now include in our financials are fixed capital, working capital, turnover, and break even. And other rest will be included in our complete report. In fixed capital, we have included the price, that is the amount that is to be paid for the land and infrastructure, as we are going to take it up on a lease basis. And it also includes the cost of machinery, equipment, legal expenses, interest on fixed capital. And the total fixed capital for our project per annum is about 16 lakhs and 80 thousands. Whereas the working cost includes salaries and wages, and this is being calculated per annum per month initially. Then it is multiplied into 12 to get into per annum. So the salaries and wages for per month is 70,000. Raw material cost takes about 2 lakhs, whereas utilities such as electricity, fuel, and other water, etc., costs about 30,000. And the interest on working capital is about 20,000. So per month, the total working costs are 2.2 lakhs, whereas per annum, they turn out to be 26.4 lakhs. Whereas our turnover, like the, this is also being calculated per month initially. And the chips that we are going to produce in a month are about 4,000 cages. And also we have made a price which is low, least in the market, and also having these additional benefits of fortification. And we have priced it at 200 rupees per kg, and by which we will be getting 8 lakhs per month. And there will be also the potato edges and the peel that can be used as animal feed, and also can be we can earn some little amount in the form of that byproduct. And we as we are producing our product, and we need to pay the sales commission tax, that is at the amount of 10% on overall sales that we are going to make. So as we have expected 8.4 lakhs as our sales, then the 10% will be 84,000. And hence total per 1 month, we will be earning about 7.56 lakhs. And per annum, we are rounded it off to 90 lakhs. And also the break even. For the break-even quantity, what we need to take is the fixed cost, and that is divided by the price of unit cost minus that of the cost per unit production. So the total fixed cost that we have incurred is 16.8 lakhs, whereas the unit price is 200 rupees per kg, and the cost of production for 1 kg of chips is 90 rupees. So we will be getting around 15,300 cages. And after selling of 15,300 cages, our company will be achieving break-even point. And basically, we will be starting it as a pilot project. Then later, we will go ahead. And if the product is being successful in the market, then we'll go ahead with the venture capitalists, as our friends have already mentioned. And then we'll make our project a bigger one. Next will be continued by
I'll take the next one, and this is the probably last slide before we finish. So why should a person invest in our product? Why should a person invest in our startup? So we have done our own SWOT analysis as any other company, and our strength is innovation, that we are based on research and development, and we believe in proper R&D to facilitate better product and also affordable prices. We have also opportunities that there is increasing awareness among people for going for healthy products and mineral fortified products for getting their own well-being. And another thing is very high mineral deficiency rates. So all those things will fuel the FICA foods to rise higher. Our weakness is that it's a beginning stage of our company, and we have just developed a seed idea. We are yet to implement it on a pilot project, which is the big first step we are going to do now. Also, there's limited funding. So we are here to solve this kind of weakness, so that if we get funding here, we will be able to go for the next product. Threat, again, it's high competition in RT and RTC sector, but we have our innovation edge. So I'm sure that will not be a bigger threat for us. And again, there is a dependence on urban market, that urban markets are more known about these kind of things. But we are going to plan with the government, and we are going to reach to the rural areas in order to especially remove the malnourishment and anti-malnourishment drives are taken by the government. And we want to provide food for them, for the children in the rural area. Can you go to the next slide? And Nihar, just conclude it, please. Nihar, unmute, please.
Sorry for the technical glitch. Concluding this one, as we have already discussed, in the health and nutrition sector, there is a large girth of micronutrient supplementation, So with this ready to cook and ready to eat micronutrient supplementation, that is fortification, we will fix that gap. And also with our solid innovative research and creative marketing strategy, we are going to come up with a better marketing strategy to for the better penetration. As Samprit has mentioned, it's basically now mainly focused on urban areas. We are planning to go it for the rural areas also. And our strength will outdo our weaknesses, a far bigger margin, and the innovation and affordability of our product along with our comprehensive strategy will make sure that it is succeeded in the existing one. And as our tagline says, health is the main issue, health is the main priority. We'll try to make a healthy India.
Thank you.
Thank you guys, and we appreciate your questions.
Wow, that's a great logo and excellent idea to fortify chips and provide chips that are not fried and rather baked and enriched. Wow, we love that logo there and everything you put in a tremendous effort, and there's a lot of idea here, an innovative approach.